do we understand the location between different places, maybe direction, and even the distance between different places over this earth? Because the shape of the earth is round, right? The shape of the earth is round. That is why it becomes difficult for us to locate different places in over this earth. For example, here imagine it's India, it's just a rough diagram, and here there is Europe. How do you calculate the distance between these two places? So, to know the position and distance and even the direction, it might be from west to east, north to south, we have network of lines which are drawn on the globe. Can you see horizontal line here like this? These are called as latitudes, and the vertical lines, can you see here? These are called as longitudes. When these two lines are drawn, it intersects at the right angle and creates a network which are called as grid and which are also called as graticule. Now let's learn about latitudes. Students, you already know about latitudes, right? Can you see these horizontal lines here? These are called as latitudes. Latitude is an imaginary line which joins all the places which have the same angular distance, north or south from the equator. This is equator. Equator is the longest line of the latitude, which is called as Great Circle. Why is it longest? Because from the pole, the earth bulges. That is why the equator is the longest line of the latitude, which is called as Great Circle. Other lines of the latitude are shorter length. Other lines of the latitude are shorter length. And all the lines are parallel to the equator. These doesn't meet the equator. All the other latitudes never meet the equator because it is parallel to equator. Now let's learn about some important latitudes. You know about equator, right? So equator is 0 degree latitude, which is also called as Great Circle. Next to equator, that is north to equator, we have Tropic of Cancer, which is 23.5 degree north latitude, and under equator, that is on the south of equator, you have Tropic of Capricorn, which is 23.5 degree south latitude. And below Tropic of Capricorn, you have Antarctic Circle, which is 66.5 degree south latitude. And above Tropic of Cancer, you have Arctic Circle, which is 66.5 degree north latitude. Above Arctic Circle, you have here North Pole, and below Antarctic Circle you have South Pole, which is 90 degree north and 90 degree south latitude. Now let's see what are longitudes. You know the meaning of longitudes, right? Can you see these vertical lines over here? These are called as longitudes. These are also imaginary lines which you do not see on the earth, but you find it on the globe. Why do we use it? To know the directions or location of different places on the earth. Students, these are also imaginary lines that intersects equator. Where is the equator? This is the equator. These lines intersects the equator. That means this part. It intersects the equator at right angle, joining north to south like this. It joins north to south are called as longitudes. All lines of longitudes are of equal length. All the lines of the longitudes are of equal length, where latitude equator is of longest length, whereas other latitudes are in the shorter length, and longitudes are of equal length. These longitudes are also called as meridians. These longitudes are called as meridians. Meri means mid and dian means day. The meridian which passes through the Greenwich, let's take this as an example, clear this longitude. The meridian which passes through the Greenwich, that is England, has been chosen as prime meridian, which has been chosen as prime meridian. What does the prime meridian do? What is it? It plays the same role what equator plays. Equator, this is equator, fine. Equator, what does it do? It divides the globe into two parts, that is into northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Same way, even prime meridian divides the globe into two parts, that is eastern hemisphere and western hemisphere. Clear? Okay. So this prime meridian is
marked as 0 degree longitudes. It is marked as 0 degree longitude. Clear? And equator. Equator is marked as 0 degree latitude. So, in total, there are 360 longitudes. There are 360 longitudes. East of the prime meridian. Let's take this as prime meridian. Clear? East of the prime meridian, there are 180 longitudes. And west of the prime meridian, there are 180 longitudes. Clear? Okay. So, students, the zone between the prime meridian, the zone between the prime meridian and 180 east longitudes are called as eastern hemisphere. Clear? And opposite zone is called as western hemisphere.
Longitude and time. The best means of measuring time is by the movement of the Earth, the Moon, and the planets. The sun regularly rises and sets every day, and naturally, it is the best timekeeper throughout the world. Local time can be reckoned by the shadow cast by the sun, which is the shortest at noon and longest at sunrise and sunset. When the prime meridian of Greenwich has the sun at the highest point in the sky, all the places along this meridian will have midday or noon. As the earth rotates from west to east, those places east of Greenwich will be ahead of Greenwich time, and those to the west will be behind it. The rate of difference can be calculated as follows. The earth rotates 360 degrees in about 24 hours. Which means 15 degrees an hour or 1 degree in 4 minutes. Thus, when it is 12 noon at Greenwich, the time is 15 degree east of Greenwich, which will be 15 into 4 is equal to 60 minutes, that is 1 hour ahead of Greenwich time, which means 1 p.m. But at 15 degree west of Greenwich, the time will be behind Greenwich time by 1 hour. That is, it will be 11 a.m. Similarly, at 180 degrees, it will be midnight when it is 12 noon at Greenwich. At any place, a watch can be adjusted to read 12 o'clock when the sun is at the highest point in the sky, that is, when it is midday. The time shown by such a watch will give the local time for that place. You can see that all the places on a given meridian of longitude have the same local time.
Now let's learn what is the meaning of local time. The time according to the longitude of a place or according to the position of the sun at that place is known as local time. The sun shining vertically over the longitude. Imagine this is sun. The sun is shining vertically over the longitude. It is 12 noon at that place. The place, the countries which are present here, it is 12 noon at that place. All the places situated in the same meridian have the same local time. It is 12 noon at that place. It might differ, the time might differ in other places. Clear? So every longitude has its own local time. Now let's discuss what is standard time. We know what is local time now, right? As the local time differs from place to place, right, local time differs from place to place, it would lead to confusion. To avoid this confusion, many countries follow same time, that is a uniform time throughout the country.
Understand, this uniform time which is followed throughout the country is called as standard time of that country. Like in India, the longitude which passes through Allahabad of Uttar Pradesh, this 82.5 degree east longitude is considered as the standard meridian of our country. Understand, the time based on this meridian is called as Indian Standard Time. We call it IST. It is 5 hours 30 minutes ahead Greenwich Meridian time.
The countries which are having large longitudinal extent, or the longitudinal extent is large, like more than 45 degrees of longitude, then there is often difference of about 3 to 4 hours between one part of the country to another. For example, let's take this as 0 degree, this as 20 degree longitude, 40 degree longitude, 60 degree longitude. So we'll take this as one country, okay? So what happens here, you'll have one time, here you'll have different time, you'll have difference of time there. So that is why you have different time zones around the place. So the whole globe is actually divided into 24 such time zones, 24 such time zones, whereas each zone differs from other by only 1 hour. There are large countries like Russia, USA, Canada, which has different time zones. For example, Russia is having 11 time zones, USA and Canada are having 5 time zones, Australia is having 3 time zones, whereas India is having only 1 time zone. Now let's learn about international dateline. What is international dateline? Can you see here this line? This line is called as international dateline. Students, the problem of time in different countries of the world was solved first by standard time, then by zonal time. But when the people started traveling across the ocean during the time of circumnavigation of the world, this brought a new problem. What was the problem? They had the problem in keeping the correct date and day in a week. How is it? Let's see now. This line passing through 180 degree meridian, that is diametrically opposite to the Greenwich Meridian time. This line is called as international dateline. Why is it called international dateline? It is called international dateline because the date and the day is changed. The date and the day is changed whenever the people passes through this line by ships or aeroplane. Students, remember, this is west and this is east. Okay, it will be easy for me to explain. Any ship crossing this line from west to east or east to west. Let's see west to east first. That means from Asia to North America, when anybody is traveling, it takes a day twice. For example, if you are here on Monday, when you reach here next day, it is again Monday itself. That means a day repeats twice. That means it takes a day twice. Clear? Okay, let's see vice versa. When somebody is traveling from North America to India, that is, or Asia, what happens? It drops one day. That means if you are here on Monday, next day you have to reach Tuesday, right? No, it skips a day or drops a day where you will reach here on Wednesday. This is the speciality of this international dateline.